Hello and welcome to Session 10, Design Reports in Power BI. I'm Andrew Conniff, a Microsoft Technical Trainer specializing in data and AI. And today we'll explore the journey of data analysis using Power BI. Let's dive right in. In this session, we will discuss understanding Power BI report structure and report objects and selecting the appropriate visual type to use, formatting and configuring visualizations, and exploring interactive features of visuals. Power BI has a variety of visuals. Each provide a unique way to visualize data. Visuals present the important information and insights in a compelling and insightful way. The report consumers rely on visualizations for initial impressions as a gateway to the underlying data. In Power BI Desktop, each visual is represented by an icon in the visualizations page. The type of visuals that are available include charts, maps, cards, tables, matrix, and many more. Selecting an icon from the pane places the visualization on the report canvas for us, and depending on the visual or the data type of the fields that we add into the visual, we will see the change in the visualization type by selecting those different visuals from the visualization pane. Often we use a combination of visuals in a report, such as the cards and the tables and the charts and the slicers and so on. It's important to use the right number of visuals on a page and then size and position those visuals strategically. Consider the number of visuals, including slicers, to use on each report page. More visuals might not achieve the desired effect. Try providing information with drill-through pages and report page tooltips. When positioning visualizations, the best practice is to place the most important visual in the top left corner of your report, as report readers often will most likely start from the left and read to the right. The visuals in the report will interact with each other. Selecting an element in one visual will update the other visuals in relation to your selection as determined in the model and the data flow directionality. When designing a report, understand the visual interaction and consider how it might affect the user experience. Consider how the hierarchies will affect how the data is displayed in the visual and navigation of the experience of our report users. Determine the hierarchy path of the visuals for a pleasing and concise experience. It is important to choose an effective visualization, displaying the data in the best way possible. Power BI has over 30 visuals, so selecting the right visual is critical in telling a compelling story with the data and helping users quickly gain insights from the report. When selecting the fields that we want to display in the visualization, experiment with all the different visualization types to find the one that works best. Additional visuals are available from Microsoft App Store, or you can import a custom visual. Power BI includes the following out-of-the-box visuals: tables and matrix. The table is a grid that contains related data in a logical sense of rows and columns. The table supports two dimensions and the data is flat, which means that duplicated values are displayed and not aggregated. The matrix visual looks similar to the table visualization. However, it allows us to select one or more elements, rows, columns, and visuals in the matrix to cross-highlight other visuals on the report page. Power BI Desktop has a variety of bar and column chart visualizations that present specific data across different categories in a stacked or clustered format. The stacked format will stack the information items on top of each other. Line and area charts help present trends over time. The basic area chart is based on the line chart with the area between the axis and lines filled in. The main difference between these two chart types is that the area chart highlights the magnitude of change over time. Pie and donut charts show us the relationship of parts of the whole by dividing that data into segments. From a data analyst perspective, these charts are not as useful because interpreting the data that they present can be difficult, but they are best used for illustrating percentages or part of the whole. Tree maps display data as sets of nested rectangles. It falls into the same category as the pie and donut charts in terms of the data analysis usefulness, but it is useful if you want to show attributes by using size, color coding, spot patterns, exceptions, or outliers. Or if you have a large number of hierarchical data and a bar chart can't handle the large number of values. Combo charts are a combination of a column chart and a line chart, and they can have one or two y-axes. This chart lets us illustrate measures in a single visual, compare multiple measures with different value ranges, and conserve space on a report. Cards display a single value, a single data point. The type of visualization is ideal for visualizing important statistics that we want to track on our Power BI dashboard or report, such as total value, year-to-date sales, or year-over-year change. The funnel displays a linear process that has sequential connected stages where items flow sequentially from one stage to the next. This is useful when the data is sequential and we want to calculate outcomes by stages or revealing bottlenecks in a linear process. A radial gauge chart has a circular arc and displays a single value that measures progress toward a goal or a target. And the waterfall visual, also known as a bridge chart, shows running total as values are added or subtracted, which is useful in displaying a series of positive or negative changes. The scatter chart visualization is effective when we want to compare large numbers of data points without regard to time. For maps, we have more than one type available. A bubble map displays precise geographical locations of data points on the map. A fill map uses shading, tinting, or patterns to display how the value differs in proportion across geographical regions. A shape map uses color to display relative comparisons of geographical regions. We use a slicer to filter the other visuals on a page. Slicers provide a more advanced and customized way of filtering compared to the filters pane, which is suited to more basic filtering operations. The different types are list, dropdown, and buttons. The Q&A feature allows us to ask natural language questions and get answers in the form of a visual. In addition to the out-of-the-box visualizations in Power BI Desktop, hundreds of other developers have created a multitude of visuals to choose from. If a specific visual is required, it is likely to be found in the marketplace. Additionally, Power BI makes it possible to build your own visual. Power BI Desktop provides a variety of options for customizing how selected visuals look, such as the colors and the format of the text that they contain, and each of these options is used to determine what impact they will have on each visual. Common formatting options include the title, where we can bold or change the color, and the aim is to clearly describe what the data is doing, and then we have the background. We can set the background as an image or to a color, for the visual and for the page, and the border. We set the border around a visual to isolate the visual from other elements on the canvas. In general, if this section is available, you'll be able to set the precise size and place for your visual on the canvas. It can also be useful to ensure that you have aligned specific visuals consistently. Data colors set the colors that you want to use for the data values in the visual. It's best to use the same color scheme throughout the report. Data labels change the font size and the colors for all the labels in the visual. Try to use solid colors so the labels are clearly visible. Add a customized tooltip that appears when you hover over the visual. A tooltip is a great feature because it provides more contextual information and detail to data points on a visual. We can sort the data displayed in our visuals so that the display is exactly how we want them to be. Sorting helps display the most important data in a logical way, such as alphabetical or a numerical order. This basic task can help stakeholders make big business decisions. For example, displaying products with the highest sales first helps end users see product popularity among the customer base. Similarly, products with low sales can be identified. Conditional formatting in Power BI Desktop allows for things like customized cell colors, including color gradients based on field values or representing cell values with data bars or KPI icons or active web links. Use conditional formatting to highlight or differentiate the data that is displayed in the visual. This allows users to see key data insights at a glance. Here we see conditional formatting used in two visuals, a table and a matrix, where it is possible to set the different condition on a column. The Power BI conditioning function automatically detects the highest and the lowest number in each column and applies the background coloring according to the values. To remove conditional formatting, select the Value tab on the Visualizations pane, right-click or context-click the value field that you set the formatting against, and then select Remove Conditional Formatting and then select the type that you want to remove. The page layout of reports will likely depend on the business requirements, the context of the underlying data, and the output requirements. This is an example of a badly designed report. This is a better designed report. When designing a report layout, choose the correct format. Collaborate with stakeholders to understand the requirements for the report, including format, data to display, and other variables. Consider the audience of the report. The goal is to provide the audience with the information they need in the most optimal way. Consider the different needs that the end user may have, such as hearing, motor, cognitive, or visual impairment. To meet these needs, create a report that offers accessibility experience. Make it easier to navigate and understand by keyboard or screen reader users. Consider the visuals and the visual elements. Carefully consider each visual element that you plan on using in the report. Everything should have a purpose. And consider how each element will look to your report users. The most information, understood immediately, is the goal. Power BI uses default highlighting to reflect selections made in one visual across other visuals in the report. However, we can modify these interactions as needed. When multiple visuals are present on a report page, they interact with each other. It's important to understand that these interactions and how they work and observe how the report page changes when a selection is made. To control visual interactions and ensure desired user experience, follow these steps. First, activate the visualization by selecting it. Then, click the Edit Interactions button to access the Visual Interactions options. Select Edit Interactions to display the visualization interaction controls. Power BI will add filter and highlight icons to the other visualizations on the report page. To customize the interactions and behaviors of your report, use the visual interaction controls. And those were first, we're going to choose a visualization and navigate to the Format tab in the ribbon. Second, we're going to select Edit Interactions. And then thirdly, we're going to modify the interaction. We're going to click the corresponding interaction icon. And then the Applied section is indicated in bold. The highlight icon represents cross-highlighting, the filter icon signifies cross-filtering, and the none icon removes the interaction entirely. By editing these interactions, we can control how visualizations impact each other, including filtering and highlighting specific data as required. This slide demonstrates a bar chart using the products hierarchy. On the right image, we see that the visual has already had drill down selected. So now we see the bars representing subcategory instead of category like in the first image on the left. When selecting a hierarchy for a visual, navigate through the hierarchy. This predefined drill path provides a structured way to explore data at a different level of granularity. To drill down, simply use the hierarchy icons or the Go to Next Level in the hierarchy button. To move back up the hierarchy, click the Drill Up button. It goes back to the previous level, providing a way to summarize the data. By leveraging hierarchies and drill down, drill up functionality in Power BI, we can easily explore and analyze data at different levels of detail, gaining valuable insights from our visualizations. Now let's see some of these features and check performance in this demonstration. We've added plenty of visuals to our report pages, and rather than rebuild this entire report, I want to do a walkthrough of what's on here, and then we're going to take a little bit of a look at the performance, and we're going to talk about how to measure the performance in here. So as you can see, we have like an image, we have bar charts with trend lines, and the lines are going to change when we select different items. So just to reiterate, our report page filters on what is selected, and we have used DAX in the past to either remove filters or enhance the filters or change the filters in some way. So you can see here we have slicer controls. When we go in, we set them how we want them. We can set the font colors and all of that. We have different icons we can use and tooltips we can add. We have our sales by country and category. In our x-axis, we've got our values. We have our legend is on. We can turn that on or off. And it all fits on the page pretty well. So we can see what's happening. We've got more than one page. I've got my same
slicer here, and I'm just looking at my other visual. We'll select that. We can see what that is. Okay. That is a matrix. So we have the matrix, and we can also tell there's no dimensions added on there because there's no opportunity to drill down. And then we have our performance page. And here we've got our sales of the target by the month. And here you see sales target and month on the axis. And over here, we've got the same thing with our sales and our target shown in a different way. We've got our cards at the top, and we can filter then based on the year. Okay, we have our default setting for how this is going to open. So we will come back and enhance this report in upcoming modules. But for now, what I want to point out is if we look at our performance on the page, go to the optimize page, if I show the performance analyzer, I can start recording from here. And there's a problem with this, and I'm going to show you what it is. So nothing's happened yet. I'm recording, but if I go to the profit page, we see values are showing up. If I go to our main report page, all these values look pretty good. We open this up and we can see there is the visual display, the image, if there's any DAX. This just happens to be the image. Let's open one with some DAX. And here we have a slicer. We have the DAX run index query view, our sales, and here we show, 106 milliseconds. So these are all very fast. This is all loading very fast. Well, Power BI does quite a bit to help us out. Go back here and I stop recording, which is basically recording the performance, and then we can go through and analyze a lot. So everything I did was recorded, but that wasn't the real number. So if I clear the report, right, start monitoring your report to see the details of what the time it takes to do any of these. If I go to a new page, start recording, and I go to the overview, still very fast. So the clear just clears our results, but we want to clear the cache. So we did see in our file, if we go to our options and settings, options, we can clear the cache. So it shows that there's 12.7 megabytes of caching data. Now, before I do this, make sure I'm on a different page. Let's go ahead and restore. Let's clear the cache and we'll see what happens. So there's 0 bytes, cancel out of there. I go here, I start recording, also very fast. Okay, so let's go back to this page. Let's clear the cache while we're on a different page and let's see how long this takes. Options and settings. And there's still 0 bytes in the cache. There's nothing there. Okay, stop recording. Just to check it one more time, start it, go to the biggest page that we've got, very quick. So here we do have a different value. We are getting slightly longer load times than we did the first time coming from the blank page. So another way to clear the cache to make sure that you have everything is, yeah, with this page one, we'll leave that one. We'll stop our recording. We'll leave the page the way it is, save our file so that we save our page. And then we're going to close this instance and we're going to reopen it. Right, here we are in the open page. And we're going to go to optimize, performance analyzer, start recording, and go to the largest page. Now we're seeing we have really cleared the cache and we get the actual value of how long it takes for everything on this report page to load. So when we design our report pages, we want to make sure that whatever is visible is important. And we're going to learn how to use bookmarks and slicers to show less data on our pages in the upcoming modules and get a more performant module that loads much better and then allow our users to drill down and see what's happening. That brings us to the end of this demonstration.
This concludes our session. There are many ways to continue your learning journey. We encourage you to watch other videos in this course or search out your next favorite topic at Microsoft Learn at aka.ms/learn.